So not going to talk in detail about all the concepts, just introduction about why we are going to talk about this distributed systems, right? So before going into the real topic of distributed systems, you gonna learn about what is your LAN and WAN, right? The local area network and the wide area network. The both the LAN and WAN gives a connection between the computers based upon the different locations. And in LAN the computers may be small, and in WAN the number of computers could be more, and the space among the computers will vary from the LAN to WAN, right? So now what happens in distributed system is, it's again going to be an interconnection of computers, but what happens is, it can be either the connection between the different computers, it can take place either in the wide environment or in a wireless environment, and the space or the connection between the different computers, it is independent of the location. So the different computers will be connected irrespective of its different locations, and it will be the number of computers connected, it will vary from a few computers to millions of computers. That we call it as the distributed systems. So now we can say, as an example of a distributed system, the resource or a process can vary. For example, when I want a process to be running on a particular system, that process may be dependent upon the different resources. That resources can be independent of the location. So hence what happens is, to talk about how the distributed system works, we can talk about something called as this, the transparency, right? So different transparencies happens due to these factors. One of the kind of transparency, we call it as the access, the location, the relocation, the migration, replication, concurrency, and the failure kinds of transparency. So now we are going to talk about the transparency. So the various transparency we can talk, like in terms of access, location, relocation, migration, replication, concurrency, and the failure. So here we are talking about transparency in terms of when a process is going to access some resource, or a resource is going to be given by a required process. So now in the case of this access transparency, the process can be said that whether it is accessed or not from a different location. And location transparency in terms of how the object is located, and relocation transparency in terms of how the object is going to be relocated, and migration in terms of how the object is going to be migrated from one place to another place, and replication is when object is going to be replicated, what happens to a distributed system concept, and concurrency when multiple concurrent systems are just going to access our distributed systems. And last we will talk about the failure, wherein one object is going to be failed, what is how the system is going to recover and take the other networks, computers, right?